Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on the show, if you're using or thinking about using managed private networking for cloud services or interoffice communications, today we're going to take a close look at Azure ExpressRoute for Office 365, a premium way to connect to the service. We'll explain how it works and what to expect, and some of the benefits ranging from improved data privacy to predictable performance and availability. By networking expert Paul Andrew. Welcome.
Great to be here. So last time I was here, we talked about the scope of the Microsoft network that Office 365 uses, what we do to manage traffic in it, and the tools you have to plan and optimize network performance.
We provide a lot of great tips, and if you were an admin watching, you probably might have been wondering, what if I've got a managed private WAN that I want to connect to get some better or predictable performance?
So before now, the answer would have been that you have to have an internet connection to connect to Office 365. And we do provide security on internet connections. All connections are secured with SSL, and optionally other technologies like RMS, DLP, and MFA. And you can also manage performance and availability for internet connections, but some of you may want more. You're looking for a premium network connection where you can work with a single network operator who can provide direct connectivity to Microsoft networks. Today, you might have multiple sites, and you might have an off-site data center that are all connected using a private managed WAN. And then to connect to Office 365, you'd have a separate public internet connection to do that. So with ExpressRoute for Office 365, you can add connectivity from your private WAN directly into Microsoft networks, providing routing for most of the Office 365 traffic for your productivity use.
And we know a lot of you out there have been investing for years in order to gain control over traffic passing to and from your network and your organization. But what other benefits are there?
Right. This is all about getting control. And having control over your network connection means you can have better increased data privacy, predictable performance, and better availability. And so all of the Office 365 workloads, including Exchange Online, SharePoint Online, Skype for Business, and OneDrive for Business, will connect over ExpressRoute. However, you still need to have a public internet connection for a few of the services that we use, particularly for accessing an on-premises identity provider for sign-in, also for Office 365 Pro Plus license activation, and also for the downloads for Office 365 Pro Plus if you're using WebDirect.
So internet connectivity is important. I know a lot of people are thinking, well, that Office 365 Pro Plus installer is around a gigabyte in size. Why can't I use the private WAN in that case to install? Well, most people actually are. So if you have an organization of that size, you're probably using things like Configuration Manager to push out those installations of Office 365 Pro Plus. And now we've even announced that Background Intelligent Transfer Service is also enabling bandwidth throttling in the background as well for the Office 365 Pro Plus installation. So a lot of great news there. Now you mentioned performance earlier. How does that get better?
Right, so let's talk about that a little bit and what predictable performance means. Mm-hmm. If you're using the internet to connect to Office 365, you're paying for a certain amount of bandwidth with an internet service provider. And typically that internet service provider will work with a number of other network operators to backhaul your traffic back to the Microsoft network. So you don't have discussions with or control over the route that those network operators use because you really don't talk to them at all. Right. And so, you know, remember last time we talked about that ferry analogy? This is a little bit like, think about you're driving one of those cars off the ferry. Mm-hmm. I mean, there was like 700,000 other cars at the end of the show driving off, and you've still got to get home. And depending on what the congestion is with those other cars and what the weather is like, you might take one route or another route, or you might give up and take a taxi to get home. And so your time to get home is really unpredictable, and your route is also unpredictable. So imagine if you had a network service provider who could build you your own road from the ferry terminal to your home. Then your route is going to be predictable, and your time to get home is going to be very predictable as well. That's a little bit like what ExpressRoute gives you.
Right. So it doesn't necessarily mean that if you're on the public internet that your route home, in this case, your route to and from the data centers, is much slower. It could be the same speed, in fact, but you've got predictable routing using this private managed network.
Right. And so the third benefit is about availability. So each circuit that is provisioned for ExpressRoute has two physical connections, actually into two physical routers as well. And we offer a 99.9% uptime SLA on the Microsoft networking components, including everything from the Microsoft data center to the ExpressRoute router that the network connectivity provider connects to. We don't, of course, provide, as Microsoft, an SLA for the network connectivity provider equipment. You talk to them, of course, about that. And we even allow you to have multiple circuits in ExpressRoute, and they can even be from separate network connectivity providers, giving you even more availability options.
So I know a lot of people are wondering how they can actually take advantage of this today. So why don't you give us some background to some of the scenarios that you'll be able to use as this gets rolled out?
All right, so the simplest scenario is that you are an existing Azure ExpressRoute customer, and you're using that for connectivity to Azure services. And so the good news there is that Azure and Office 365 services are hosted in the same Microsoft data centers.
And a lot of people don't even know this.
Right, and we use the same worldwide network to connect those data centers together and to connect them to the internet. So if you're connected there, you're already connected. Now, there will be some configuration changes required, and we're currently working to ensure that as many of those configuration changes are handled by Microsoft or by the network connectivity provider, and hopefully none will be required by the end customer.
Right, and one of the things we pointed out in the last show is even though you're coming from maybe an on-premises environment for things like mail or file sync and share, you still want to be doing things like capacity planning, using the tools that we talked about in the last show to actually see how much more traffic you're going to use. Because even with that managed connection, you'll need to know how much more headroom you're going to need for those connections back to the data centers.
Right, yeah, if you have more than 25 users, we do recommend that baselining, seeing how much traffic you're using now. You're very likely to need to increase the amount of capacity you have on your ExpressRoute connection.
So what's our second scenario then?
All right, so the second scenario is where you have multiple offices and probably an offsite data center, mm-hmm. and you've got this private managed WAN already set up. If that private WAN is run by a network connectivity provider who is also an ExpressRoute partner with Microsoft, then they can provision Office 365 and Microsoft Network directly onto that managed WAN. So it just appears as an additional site that you have on your private WAN.
Right, so it looks like from a networking perspective, almost like our data center is one of the nodes in your hub and spoke model of your private WAN going as another one of those data centers, right?
Yeah, exactly right. So you've got, you've got very similar concepts in terms of the way you use an offsite data center and how Office 365 might look.
And what are the other ways that you can connect?
So the other scenario that we wanted to talk about is actually called the exchange provider model.
Okay, not to be confused with the exchange server and the mail service.
Right, it's called that because the connection is done at a network exchange, mm-hmm. Sort of similar to old school telephone exchanges there. So this third scenario is where the exchange provider actually gives you just a couple of network ports on a router, and it's up to the customer as how they connect up those network ports. So this is typically useful if you have a very large network and you may already have connectivity at one of those co-location facilities where our ExpressRoute routers are, or you do manage your own deployments of individual network links. So having those ports just be made available that you can connect to is just exactly what you want.
Good stuff, Paul. Thanks for joining us today. Of course, all this news and more can be found on the Office blogs, or you can catch us Wednesdays or as news breaks on Office Mechanics. Thanks everyone for watching, and goodbye for now. We'll be right back.